on Vayne, I just want to be able to free farm as much as I can, get to level 6, at which point I have opportunity to try to outplay people and do stuff like that. But yeah, I'm going to be right back real quick. So thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll see you all soon with this Vayne bot lane game. Alright, I'm back. Alright, what's up, guys? Welcome back to the stream. Shouts to TDMB74. Welcome to the stream. Alright, so like I said, playing Vayne bot, I went defensive setup, it's my specialty, and I got a Duran shield as well, so I'm gonna be fairly tanky. Our ping's been at 85 all day, not sure why, it's pretty annoying, but it's fine. Like I said, if it goes up to like 100 something, then that's where I have a problem. So I'm gonna start Q. Give him a decent leash and headbot. Gonna be a little bit late, but shouldn't miss out on too much. Missed the XP for one. That was annoying. Those range creeps all focused that one creep. They didn't even bother switching their priority at all. So just die before we could get into lane. So that's gonna mean we're gonna hit level 2 after their lane. And it's gonna be a little bit tricky for us, but I think we'll be okay. They're shoving us in already for the early level 2. And trying to lifesteal. Caitlyn's fairly low. Still pretty heavily level 1. Oh, that guy has headshot up. I want to make him use it to CS. Force me back. Getting pressured in early. I have one pot, but I do not want to use it yet. I smell black magics. And can I get that? Yep. It's pretty hard to last hit with this setup, just because you're losing out on some damage that you'd normally have, but it's definitely not that bad. Okay. Need help. Taking a lot of damage there, they might try to dive me. What's the CS at? 15 to 10.
Oh,
trying to bait the gank. Took too much damage. That sucked. I'm gonna get Duron's blade and two health pots. I used barrier, but the ignite tick outlasts the barrier, so I ended up dying for it. Kinda sucks. The dark should feel me. Should get most of these creeps. Kurt's on the can creep, so stalling out long enough for me to make it. Oh, Lulu hit those ones though. Barely made it back. Didn't get any of them. Early game in this lane, really just want to farm it out. Lulu was duking out a little bit too much for me to be comfortable with. I think we should have just focused on trying to get as much creeps as we could. And also, like, I think if she was kind of trading a little bit less with Annie, it would have been better. But my death there didn't have anything to do with that. I just should have been a little further back. They were paying for me to go to try to bait out the gank, but I didn't have to walk up that far. That was a mistake. Kaylin has Vamp Scepter now, and I'm still sitting on my shield and a Duron's Blade, so I'm behind. 8 CS, but they've also killed me. Just want to get to level 6, get my ultimate. I mean, just start dropping trinkets. I have a pink there. Go try to kill it. Can't really fight that safely. They're stronger than this right now. Annie's been wailing on me. Just got her stun up, gotta be careful. I'm gonna drop my trinket here. I got Siobhan jungle, who really just wants to farm quite a lot. Flash. I didn't expect to get the shield there. Otherwise I would not have flashed. Damn. Good snipe. Yeah, I don't really want to fight. I should probably have specified that to Lulu after the initial stuff. I just want to go for farm, and that's really all I want to do. We were only behind 9 CS, so what was happening was okay. But we duked it out a little too much. Tried to go back in and knock him back. Ended up getting killed for it. I had no barrier up at that point. It's my bad. That guy's probably dead. He has ult up. He decided to flash instead. Probably thought his combo was gonna kill him, and then he just barely lives, so he decided to flash for the finisher. Damn. Getting bought pretty hard. It'd be worse if I didn't have defensive setup, by the way. That did not have anything to do with the deaths. Yeah, if I make it out of lane like 10 CS down on Vayne, then I'm pretty okay with that. Annie K is not a lane that I want to fight at all early game. I just want to try to farm out against them. Annie's level 6. We're still both level 5. Kate's got a BF sword on me. It's not good. It's almost impossible to lane versus him now. Getting zoned. to level 5. This is so rough. She has flash stun up. Actually, her flash is down. But she should have ult up. Creeper is coming into our turret. They can pressure us on it pretty easily. Almost level 6. Damn, that hit me. Probably gonna die of us, to be honest. Doubles, baby. Just gonna stand here and fight him. Should get him. Oh, he got two of us. I was in the middle of a big creep wave. Pretty sure I tanked a decent amount of creep damage. I only had Barry up. That was still really good for us, and I got a double kill out of it, but it could have been better. I really wanted to get 1550 gold for a BF sword. Probably just have to go build here. And Zerkers. Start getting points in W, because now I'm gonna be getting Blade Rune King just by virtue of having that much gold on it back. So instead of maxing Q, I'm gonna start getting points in W since I'm gonna be getting attack speed soon. Have no summoners up, flashed up in 20. If I orb block or micro a little bit better on the Shyvana, that would've been fine. Probably could've stalled her out long enough to get Wukong enough freedom to survive. I don't know. I thought I was just gonna die. Just want to do as much damage as I could before I fell. It's pretty brutal. Can't go up for CS. I need to lifesteal my health pull back. Probably thought Wukong was down here. Try and move mid to help. Nice job. Caitlyn's freezing bot, she's gonna push it out now. I just went mid so that they'd start pushing out bot. I could have gotten that, but I'd rather go for the wave. What's the CS at? 93 to 63. Not as close as but I'd ideally like it to be, obviously. Come on. If I knew he was going to ult himself, I would have not blocked that. Should have just given up turret and farmed the massive creep wave. That was so much free gold. I don't know why we stayed under that. That was kind of silly. Summoners. Barrier just camp, I believe. Just gonna farm this out, and I really need to get my blade. I'm super late on this. Just like massively underfarmed. Gotta catch up. Caitlyn's mid, I'm just gonna farm bot to catch up. There's no reason for me to leave lane right now. And hopefully, Wukong can go off and make plays for us. Caitlyn did die though, that's gonna be good for me. It's gonna allow me to get some farm and start catching back up. So good job, team. Shawn comes down here with red, she'll probably be able to kill me. If I had my blade completed, I'd be fine. But as of now, a little bit naked. I'm gonna go kill the white. He's coming bot. Don't think he's doing dragon. Not sure what he's doing exactly. W now. Oh, he missed. Trying to rotate on this guy. Damn. Not gonna go this way. Need Wukong mid to help hold. Pretty big wave bot. Nice job. Sean's pushing bot. There's two mid. Gragas is returning mid. If Blue can freeze that farm, that'd be great. And this huge wave bot is just coming right into me. Should be able to get my blade soon enough. Pretty happy about that. Don't really care about fighting him. He's going for the white though. What if they're roaming on me? Just gonna get blade here and then go by. Cancel this guy's recall just to be cheeky. That was not worth it, but it's funny. I just basically told him that there's a ward there and that information could have been used to kill someone that tried to use this as like a blind spot or a gank point later on. But it did cost him like 7-10 seconds of recall time, which means he's not going to be doing other stuff. So it's a trade-off, but in that situation it's probably better to just make them not realize there's a ward there. Alright. I got blade here, and I'll just get a health pot and head back bot. Caitlyn has her BT, I have my blade. She's out farming me by 30. But I think I should be able to outduel her with blade. Almost level 10. I get max strength of my W at that point. An enemy has been slain. Nice. In the dark, all is naked. Damn. And he flash stunned, and the Ziggs also went for the ultimate, which popped me before I could burst the Caitlyn. Had both summoners, but it was not worth using there. I could have gone earlier on him, probably killed him. I figured I'd be able to burst him by the time they'd respawn. but Annie moved really fast. She has her icon, or Talisman Ascension, or whatever. She just popped that and ran all the way towards me. I was just waiting for him to line up on the wall. I could have ult-ed him here with the slow, but he would have eaten away and probably just been able to flash. That's why I chose that as my time to go. Yeah, they were too close for comfort there. Should not have attempted it.
I pass judgment.
Just gonna push this out. If I can get massive and just be unkillable 1v1, then I'll be doing the best I can for my team at this point. Wukong's going off. I like it. Caitlyn used barrier when I tried to kill her, and my cooldown's gonna be up, so never mind, she's up top. Just gonna take this turret. It's probably dead. Grag's going off. Nice, we're gonna win this game. Damn, Grag's is 0-4. I thought he was doing like pretty well. I was gonna say jungle and mid are just like winning lanes pretty hard. It's actually just this Mukong going off. All of the lanes kind of lost. Almost level 11. Could duel this guy. I wanted level 11 though.
I pass judgment.
I'm gonna back, probably get a Zeal. And a pink ward.
I hear the innocent cry.
I got level 11 off this. Damn. I wanted him to help me, or share with me so I get EXP. It's gonna run bot. I don't think they should go in on that. They could move bot on me. Not gonna push out too hard by myself. They just ward that. They're probably just dragging. I think the Caitlyn knows I'm gonna try 1v1 her. He lets himself get vulnerable. And he's staying down here with me, and he's heading down here though. Thought Annie was still mid, but that's wrong. I got confused. I didn't realize they warded this. I was going to try to juke back in here, and then they were just waiting there. So actually, I just played and ran immediately. That was pretty dumb. I thought Annie was mid. I just glanced at the minimap, saw my team there. I saw two people, but I realized it too late. And at that point, I could have tried to probably run past Annie. That would have been fine, too. She didn't see me, I believe, either go in this bush or walk out, so I thought maybe she'd keep running. That's why I stood in the brush originally, but I just ended up getting pincered and dying. Pretty suck. Gotta keep pushing. They got 4-5 mid. Might be the time that I have to back. I don't think I'm gonna be useful in team fight though. they can just hold them off while I push, that'd be good too. I think they're gonna look for a dive though. Oh, damn, didn't get the stun. Okay, a bad one for one while I'm down here doing nothing. They can just hold them off, this is good for us. Yeah, this was good for us. Keep pushing this out. One animal. I'm not gonna ult for this, I'm gonna save my ult. Damn, that did not get the stun off, really. I didn't have barrier. He had his up. That sucked. Just playing like ass this game. That's all it is. Should have just been able to position for a higher success rate condemn. That one was relatively close to the wall, but I could have easily secured a guaranteed one there. Since condemn it, or is bury it, 210. He just sat there and autoed me, and I did less damage. He just died. On wings of night. I should have just died here without using summoners. There's no reason to waste ghost or flash and barrier trying to survive that two-man gank. I already knew I was dead once the Annie showed up. That was a mistake. The dark should fear me. Kaelin's down here. He got last whisper and nerds, okay. I'm back here. Going for static shiv, it's gonna help me split faster, and that's all I can afford to get right now. Stay relevant. Trap like a beast. Kaelin could probably gank me and just kill me. He's mid though. That guy is huge. I think they're gonna win the next team fight with Kaelin just having gotten like a last whisper upgrade. Gotta keep splitting. And hoping my team can continue to hold out. Technically, there should be a point where I start to. Oh my god, so close. Damn. Surprise guys wasn't able to finish them off. They're so low. Just gonna keep pushing. They're going for Baron. The dark should feel me. They are indeed. They will be purified. I got Baron, they're backing, I gotta run. Try to kill the Annie and then like, I wanted to get damage on the turret, but I barely had time since I just melted Baron and started recalling. Oh god. I fucking knew that was gonna happen. Oh, I knew it. I can't believe I just walked into that trap. was so silly. It was in the brush, so I couldn't see it, but as soon as I hit it, I was like, they're chasing me, they're gonna ult me. Damn. Icing on the top of a bad game. So brutal. That was exactly what I wanted. Sell the pink ore. Don't have a place to put it efficiently right now. And let's see. I have 1500 gold. Not enough for BF yet. Just coming. Not really in a position to go in. Probably just need to get last whisper next to stay relevant. This Kaylin's just tanking the turret. And I'm gonna just run in a certain direction because one Ziggs ult or Kaylin ult will kill me. Your turret has been destroyed. Yeah, I think if we just like communicated, me and Lulu were just like, alright, let's like try not to fight. They poke us, let's just take it. Focus on getting as much CS as we can. If we have to back earlier and give us some turret damage, that's fine. But instead, didn't really talk about anything. I was in the mindset of like, I just want to kind of farm. Lou was trying to trade. Took some bad trades. Not her, like both of us combined. And then just ended up resulting in us getting killed. And that first death where I was like walking up to try to bait the Wukong gank was really bad. I took way too much free damage there for no reason. Just gonna go back bot, keep pushing I guess. That's all I know what to do. That's all I can do right now. My vein's so rusty. I'm dead. He just like three shot me. He's too strong. He wasn't near a wall, so it's not like I could have got an angle for the condemn. I waited in the brush. If he didn't have a ward, then he would have had to walk in to start fighting me, or he could just wait for the Annie. Or he could have trapped, and with the split second of vision, he could start auto attacking me. But I was trying to get it so that he'd come close enough to the brush. I could try to tumble behind him and condemn back into the wall, but none of that ended up happening. Let's see. So this. And what's their team? Don't really have much armor. Let's just go IE. Game's pretty much over, however. No, I'm dead. I just wanted to get the auto attack shift proc on him. Probably would have killed him, but I was not in range. Started turning back, and he came. That was game. We got destroyed bot. Top mid and bot lost, but we lost the hardest. Kaylin got a little bit out of control. Wukong kept us in the game just by making like hero plays left and right, but it was not enough to make up for how badly the lanes went. If I did not go for this defensive setup that you guys probably think sucks because I just got like destroyed that game, then we would have lost lane harder. It's really just, it makes it harder to punish you early game and throughout the game as Vayne. And since Vayne doesn't really need help dealing more damage, it's a personal preference choice, but it's definitely viable to pick up something like this and start with a drawn shield. It could have worked out fine if we just tried to